Welcome to the Luke and Jake Movie Podcast.
Cheers to that.
Cheers.
Cheers to the many.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
You know, I love my birthday. I do.
Do people hate their birthday usually?
I don't know. Some people are like, I don't really want to celebrate my birthday. I love celebrating my birthday.
Yeah, you go more all out than most people I know.
Well, not. I don't really go out. I just love...
Most people I know, they don't have a party.
See, I...
They'll just, like, they might, you know, do something a little special. Like, for me, I just went for dinner with Tamsin.
Yeah.
And I was with my family. But then...
Whereas I round up
you
everyone
did
I know.
Two parties.
Yeah. And it's still not over yet.
See what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. You're right.
I don't know. I guess for me, it's like, especially turning 25, I was like, whatever.
Oh, yeah. See, for
25
me,
25
like...
of these. If I had 25 kids, the 25th kid, I'd be like...
Yeah.
Okay.
No, see, I
wouldn't even give
it
a name.
When I'm even 43... If yeah. I'm not having a huge birthday celebration, shoot me in the foot.
I celebrate every day.
Yeah.
Every day is my birthday.
No, I don't know why. This year, what did I do last year? I don't even remember. Oh, last year I was in PEI. But this year, for some reason, I was like, I want to do something fun.
Probably because you're about to get married, maybe. You're just thinking about life in a different way.
Yeah. And it's so, like, it's insane that once you're out of school, the effort that you have to make to actually see people. Especially
it's
as soon
true.
As you have.
It's actually true.
Like, I have Jess, you have Tamsin. We have each other.
That's no one else?
No, but seriously, the effort that it's... Like, there were people... I had this dinner with a group of my friends yesterday from school, and they... Like, there were some of them that live 10 minutes down the road from me, and I haven't seen them in 4 months.
Yeah.
And there's no real excuse. It's just like... I don't know.
No, I know what you mean.
Everyone is busy. Everyone has their own careers. Everyone's doing different things. So that's why I was like, and it's funny. That group of friends is like, the only times we've been seeing each other consecutively, like all at once, is because of you and Jess. Because your engagement party. Now your birthday. And the next time will be your wedding.
That's right.
Yeah. So, but I also love my birthday because I didn't have to spend money on food the past 2 days.
You look like you've been partying.
Yeah. I know.
The hair, the enormous sweater.
Well, on my birthday, I wanted to dress like this.
I think it's a good look.
Yeah. And this is our birthday bear.
This is birthday bear.
And what better way to celebrate your birthday than do a podcast? That's how loyal we are.
Talk about the movies.
That's how loyal we are.
Well, by the I'm going to Cuba.
You're going to Cuba.
So by the time most of the people will be listening to this,
yeah,
I'll be flying.
Yeah.
Be flying high in the sky.
Jake will be high in the sky in Cuba.
I'm so excited.
While I stay here doing a one-man podcast.
We can do a one-man podcast.
I think you could. I don't think I could.
I could. But if I were to do it, it'd be like 8 hours long. It would I would go on for
next.
So long.
It'd be like one of those late-night radio stations that it's just this one
guy. Do you
remember,
when I was a kid, I would go for sleepover at Brendan Burchell's house. And we would listen to this late-night radio show. All about the paranormal and about like UFOs. And the guy would be like, "Welcome to Beyond the Beyond." And then he would just talk about like, "Our next caller says that he's seen 3 UFOs in the past 3 weeks."
See, you were like a radio kid.
I liked listening to the radio.
Like Adventures of Odyssey.
Yeah.
Like honestly, I haven't listen to anything until that Serial podcast that I listened to, and for the first time I realized how much I love it because you get
it's
to visualize.
So good. Yeah,
and
yeah.
Other than watching a show, I can do things. I can wash dishes.
Yeah,
I can go on a walk. I can. No wonder people like podcasts.
I listen to podcasts while I do anything.
So yeah.
This morning I've listened to 2 podcasts.
What?
Because I did laundry and I vacuumed, and during both, just listening to podcasts. Listen to this thing about how lemmings. That whole documentary that Walt Disney did, that was a lie. Lemmings don't commit suicide. They literally threw lemmings off a cliff for this documentary, for which he won an Academy Award.
Walt Disney?
Yeah.
I've never heard of it.
It's messed up.
What podcast is that on?
That was Science Versus.
Science. So you have like a list that you just go through and listen to?
And just whenever there's a new podcast, listen it up. And then I listened to Radiolab did one about nuclear bombs and about like the checks and balances. Welcome to the Luke and Jake Movie Podcast.
This is the Luke and Jake Movie Podcast.
I'm Jake.
I'm Luke.
And we're glad that you're with us.
We are glad because today's going to be good.
Yeah, this is a war, kind of. This is a big war.
This is a big war episode.
One of the biggest wars in the movie industry, probably.
Yeah.
Is Marvel
versus DC. But before we get to that, what have you been watching?
I've been watching a bunch.
What?
Including movies that are like my favorites. Like, I watched a bunch of Gangs of New York again.
Oh.
Dude, that movie's the best. I love Gangs of New York so
amazing
much.
Moments. No, but I think that's the all around.
I think that movie's amazing.
Oh. But you must admit, there's weak moments in the movie.
Like what?
Kirsten Dunst?
She's not in the movie. Who's Kirsten Dunst?
I mean,
you mean Cameron Diaz?
They're the same person to me.
She's not bad. Is she? She's not bad at all.
I have to go back and rewatch because last time I was like, this is kind of boring.
When there's a, I think there's a line from that movie which is like a thesis statement for all of Martin Scorsese.
Ah.
And it's when Liam Neeson is dying right at the beginning and is holding his son's face and he says, never look away. That's like every Scorsese movie. He just like, we're just going to stare into this horrible, disgusting, difficult, funny, crazy, unruly kind of worlds. And we're just going to stare straight at it. Anyway. And we watched The Deer Hunter.
The Deer Hunter.
You had never seen it before.
I'd never seen it.
What were your thoughts on The Deer Hunter?
My thoughts were, that was great. Seriously. It's a great, solid movie. It is the quintessential, like, to me, an Academy Award winning movie. That's what, when I think of an Academy Award winning movie... It's those movies from the 70s. Yeah. The 70s are glory days.
The best, man. The best
like,
decade.
Like, having Godfather, Godfather 2, having that. They all have this unique
look. It's a long
look
list of movies
and style. And it's kind of what we've been talking, like, off podcast about. But those movies do allow a lot of breathing time. There's intense parts, and then there's time for you to just, like, sit with it and think about it as it's actually going, rather than just, like, hammering you with a bunch of things.
And so real. That whole movie just feels real.
Oh, yeah.
Start to finish. Nothing feels artificial or conjured. It all feels real.
I was reading up about it. Like, I didn't know. It was the first movie to actually be shot there after the Vietnam War.
They shot it in Vietnam?
Yeah. Well, like, somewhere near there.
Yeah.
I don't know if it was, like...
Southeast Asia, perhaps.
Yeah. First movie to be shot there since the war. And then the... I don't know. Christopher Walken won an Oscar.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
He was on like a diet of bananas and rice.
Yeah, it's kind of disgusting.
Yeah, he did not look good.
He looks awful in that movie.
That whole beginning wedding thing, we talked about it while we were watching. It felt like The Godfather.
Yeah.
It's so real.
They shot that over like 3 days with a group of like Russian-American extras.
How much fun that must have been.
Amazing. What else have you been watching?
I rewatched 13 Assassins.
Yeah?
Because I was so hyped about that movie after I watched it. I was like... And I wouldn't shut up about you guys. I'm never going to shut up about this movie.
It's good.
It's that good.
I'll watch it.
I
promise you I'll watch
amazing. It. It's amazing. I want more movies like that. I want more movies that just take this little chunk of history and this big world and just focus on something small that happened in it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
That's why movies I think like Saving Private Ryan are so great, because it's not World War II the movie. It's about this small group of men, you know, in this enormous sort of world.
Yeah.
So I love it for that. And it's... I mean, 45 minutes of just samurai warfare. It's amazing. Whew. And I watched The Get Down Part 2, which is horrendous. It is terrible.
Just putting it lightly.
I got it to the second part, and I realized that I didn't care at all anymore.
Yeah.
And that was so sad, because I had so much... I had optimism, and all of a sudden, there are these, like, flash animation-styled... I was telling you, it's like those dumb comics everyone made on Facebook for a while, where it's like... Sandy was never going to stop drinking, or whatever were. Some of them were a little weird. It looked like that. And there are these animations all of a sudden that will go on for 10, 12 minutes. And they're terrible. And you just wonder, what happened? What happened? Baz Luhrmann, poor guy.
Yeah.
Anyway, what have you been watching?
Budget cuts. Budget cuts. You also watched Louis C.K.
Yes. And I rewatched Dave Chappelle.
It's actually so interesting.
I love stand-up.
That Netflix is like arms. Now Netflix is like... We're going to own the live stand-up, like, release.
They've been owning it for a little while now. It's not an HBO
but
special
Dave
anymore.
Dave Chappelle, like, he's the biggest. Like,
oh, yeah.
Him and as soon as they get Kevin Hart, they've got, like...
They got them all.
And they will.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Well, they yeah, for a little while now, they've been doing that. Whereas comedians, they used to call it a Comedy Central special or an HBO special.
HBO, yeah.
Now it's just a Netflix special. Yeah. Netflix special. Oh, when's your next Netflix special? Yeah. Oh, it's my Netflix special. Yeah.
I wish I could sit on those meetings with the HBO where they're like,
what do we do?
Netflix. Like, how... they just run the world. I watched... where do I have it written down? Watch The Deer Hunter. Oh, I'm on episode 7 of Atlanta. Yeah. It was actually my favorite one.
Which one was
it? It's hilarious. It's the Black Entertainment Television with the commercials.
Oh, yeah.
Amazing.
How brilliant is it?
Amazing.
It's brilliant.
That is my favorite episode so far. It's amazing.
Yeah.
The way they comment on, like...
So funny.
And it's so funny when he's talking about, like... when he's talking about, like, are you transphobic and stuff? And Paperboy says, like, certain things, and she agrees with him. And the guy's like, but what about this? And they're like, no, we agree on that, too.
I just
love the... I thought it was...
Paperboy!
I thought it was so brilliant.
That show is so good.
I watched Alien, followed by Aliens.
Woo!
Those are some... Yeah, that was just a lot.
You're on a roll, man.
Yeah, that was a lot. I'm watching Survivor. And then I just want to touch on two shows that are out right now on Netflix. There's Riverdale and 13 Reasons Why.
13 Reasons Why I've heard a lot about.
These are two guilty pleasure shows that I strongly believe are both garbage.
Wow.
I do. I watched the first episode of 13 Reasons Why, and I've watched... I know you talked about the OA, the mystery element of something.
Yeah, and that can be a little tedious.
I believe the OA actually pays off with that.
Yeah.
13 Reasons Why, it's like upsetting the way they set up that series. It's like a girl commits suicide, she leaves 13 tapes behind, and you find out why she killed herself.
Okay.
And that's like the hook of the show, and I just think both of them, like Riverdale especially, I just think both of them are garbage.
Yeah.
And
you're watching them.
No, I'm not. No.
I've sworn off them.
I watched the first 30 minutes of 30 Reasons Why, and I watched the first 5 episodes of Riverdale.
And that was enough.
And that was just enough. And Netflix, well, it'll catch on that people don't like bad stuff.
But see, I think they do. I think Netflix is smart because they're not just focusing on making good TV shows. They're focusing on making TV shows that they'll have something for everyone.
Yeah, that's
why they made Ultimate Beastmaster.
Yeah.
I was even talking to a friend recently who said, when is Netflix going to start doing reality TV?
Yeah.
Because it can't be far away. There's going to be some Netflix reality TV thing where it's like 39 episodes of one season, and people are going to watch like an entire year of some widows. That's going to be their intro.
That's so true.
Widows.
Or they'll get some celebrity that has been and fall.
That would be what would be
like.
I hear
who's the guy that's Richard Simmons?
Yeah.
I hear they're going to do something with him. Not it's someone because
he disappeared
and what's going on.
That would be interesting, actually. Yeah.
But you know, speaking of reality shows, Survivor, it's so good.
That's what I mean, though.
It's like so damn good.
I think Netflix will come up with something like
that.
Game changer.
Like I don't. Yeah, it's hilarious. But it still has that element of, like, you just... I don't know. I love it. I get so invested in it, and it's hilarious, and it's... Like, my heart races during the tribal council.
Watching them play the game.
I'm like, who's gonna get voted out? I just love it. They still have... They have it down.
Yeah.
They released two seasons? 39. No, 34. 34.
That'll do it.
They released, like, 2 a year.
I can't believe it's still going.
Yeah. Yep.
Cool.
So we're trying something new today. A new segment, because we love our segments here.
Yes, we do.
We've stuck to them every week. These classic segments that you've all come to love.
But here's a brand new one.
Brand new one.
Speed round.
Speed round. Do you remember watching Uh-Oh?
Uh-Oh,
Speed
Round?
Remember that? That game with that girl?
Was it like a quiz show? Was it like a quiz?
No, it was like you had to dive into like muddy things and get
like
stuff
find
out.
Like all the eggs.
Yeah. And then some of them was like speed round.
The Punisher?
Like, what's 4 plus 4? What color is an orange?
But it was just the stress.
So we're doing a speed round this week.
And of course it's themed around movies. We each have 10 things. whether it's a question or yeah. What's the first that comes to your mind, or whatever, yeah. For each other, and we're gonna have to actually be quick.
So are we doing like you're all 10 at once?
Yeah.
Okay, who's going first?
I'll go first.
Okay. All 10.
Okay.
I'm bad at all my feet.
Yeah, these are good. These yeah. are good.
Okay.
Welcome to the speed round.
Speed round. Speed round. So Jake's going to ask me 10 questions, and I have to say exactly what comes to the top of my head right away.
And I got 10 of these.
10.
Okay, well.
I'm nervous.
Okay, are you ready?
No.
You're going to have to be quick, man.
Okay.
You have to be quick. Here we go. Speed okay. round.
Speed round.
Sexiest actor.
Margot Robbie.
A famous actor. Like a male.
Tom Hiddleston.
Famous movie quote that could accidentally be understood as innuendo.
I can't carry it for you. I can't carry you.
Movie that you love that everyone else hates.
Hook.
Biggest WTF moment in a movie.
Inception. At the end.
The real reason why Johnny Depp's career is falling in the toilet.
Because he sucks at acting.
The on-screen couple that is most like you and Jess.
Jim and Pam.
Which Star Wars character you would sleep with?
Daisy Ridley. And Princess Leia.
A threesome with Rey. Movie I love but you hate.
What's the one with Jimmy Stewart in the place, Washington?
Mr. Smith Goes to Washington. You hate that movie?
No, I don't even know, but I don't know it.
The worst TV show you've ever binged.
Worst TV show I've ever binged.
Ding 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 ding.
Chef's Table.
Your credit card information.
5415.
Okay, last question. If you could live in any movie universe, which would it be?
Star Wars.
There it is. That was 10.
That was 10.
You did pretty good, man.
I did pretty
good. I'm nervous now.
Yeah, you should.
I'm nervous now. It's hard. Now. It's hard. I'm scared I'm going to say something dumb.
I know. That's what I was always scared of. You know, I share a birthday with Daisy Ridley.
That's crazy.
Isn't that amazing? She's 25.
It's that my age.
I know.
92?
Okay, speed round. Jake's turn.
I'm so ready.
Are you ready?
Nope.
Ready. 3, 2, 1, go. Biggest man crush.
It's so many. Ryan Gosling.
Best song in a movie.
Now I See the Light from Tangled.
favorite Joker quote.
You wanna know how I got these scars?
Movie character you're in love with.
Ryan Gosling in Drive.
Favorite animated character.
Rapunzel from Tangled.
Favorite Leonardo DiCaprio role.
Oh, The Departed.
Movie that makes you cry.
Mr. Smith Goes to Washington.
movie that makes you laugh really hard.
This Is the End.
Your most hated movie of all time.
I even thought of this the other day. Movie I hate, probably American Sniper. I hate that movie.
Part of a movie where you audibly gasped.
You know, the one with the moment where I don't gasp a lot in movies. I'm trying to think when I go, darn, I don't
ding,
know.
Ding, ding,
Gone Girl. Twist and Gone Girl.
There you go.
Yeah, for sure.
Those are 10.
That yours was 10?
Yes.
Yours were easier.
Yours were mainly around...
You, as a person.
No, we're mainly around Ryan Gosling and
my
Rapunzel.
Well, I don't know if those are both true.
Yeah.
The best song one, probably not, but that one's definitely on my mind.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
It is beautiful.
It's perfect in the movie.
It's my favorite
and
song.
And Ryan Gosling, but that's why he's the crush is because of his character in Drive.
Really?
I rewatched a bunch of Drive not too long ago, just for the music. I was looking at bits and pieces. Dude, he's my type in that movie, man.
I gotta rewatch it, because I've only seen it once.
It's amazing. Well, there it is, folks. Speed
there
round.
It just seems outside. It got dark all of a sudden.
Yeah, dude. The rains.
Really?
The rains are coming. It's supposed to rain.
Really?
Yeah.
I had no idea. It's terrifying.
It is getting really dark. I'm going to have to move my laundry.
But that was a speed round.
Woo!
What did you think? You should answer them with us.
Yeah, answer them down below. What on-screen couple is most like Luke and Jess?
Yeah. Why? Who is it? On screen. See, I said Jim and Pam. They're on screen.
Yeah, I think that was a good answer.
Yep. Yep.
I loved your Johnny Depp answer.
Because he sucks.
Because he's a bad actor.
I was never a fan of Johnny Depp.
Yeah.
Except for Jack Sparrow the first time I saw him.
Jack Sparrow. I like him in one of Tim Burton's earlier movies, Ed Wood, where he plays just a terrible filmmaker. He's just lovably sort of strange in
that. It's just so, it's so interesting with actors how they come in waves.
I've never seen Finding Neverland. How is he in that?
Oh, he's good. Yeah, he's good in that.
And he's good in Sweeney Todd.
Yeah. It's just funny. Actors have their peaks and then they... It's just so interesting. Like, Will Smith and Johnny Depp used to own...
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah.
And now it's just like... You make a couple wrong choices with Johnny Depp. You make some bad choices in your personal life.
I think that's probably... Would be a big part of it.
Like, no actor can really hold a crappy movie on their back. Like, Elysium.
Terrible.
Like, Matt Damon can't make that a success.
That might be my worst.
Same with movie. The Great Wall in North America. Did great overseas, but Matt Damon, yeah, they can't sell things. Johnny Depp used to be able to sell anything.
Think about, like, yeah, Tom Hanks.
Yeah.
He's not a seller anymore.
No, he's not. People like him. But that doesn't make... What came out? What was the... He had so many in a row.
The hologram for
And
the
now
King.
There's this new one
he
coming had, out.
Which one?
The one the with circle, Emma Watson.
The Circle. He made the Inferno. That did terribly. And then... Did Sully sell?
Yeah, it did. Sully did.
So that was like the last thing that he did that...
Yeah. My most hated movie, Sully.
Would be Sully?
No. I think I hate some movies more, but that's the movie I hate recently. You know what we didn't say? You know what movie I watched this week?
What?
Grandpa George is Dead.
I wasn't going to bring it up.
Really?
I thought it would be a little bit too much.
No, I want to bring it up. I want to bring it up. Horn. So, Luke and Jake Movie Podcast, we have a home on Movi. So, if you're listening to this on SoundCloud, we also film it and put it up on this YouTube channel called Movi. And Movi's like Jake's baby. There's a bunch of movie analysis stuff on there, and there's talking about movies and different things like that.
Reviews and discussions
about movies. All things to do kind of with what we do on the podcast. And then, a year and a half ago, we filmed a movie that Jake wrote. Jake wrote and directed it, and it was just released on Movi. And if you haven't seen it yet, give it a watch. It's 19 minutes. And I think you'll enjoy it. People have seemed to be liking it, so...
Everyone's been very positive.
Yeah, so...
Even some people who I thought, like, really wouldn't like it, they had a lot of good things to say.
Really?
I was kind of surprised. Yeah, by a few people in particular. But people have been very nice.
Yeah.
And, I mean, I wish we could have released it sooner.
Yeah.
But I am happy it's out there.
I'm happy it's out there. And also,
and
like...
there's way more coming.
Exactly. There's way more coming down the pipe. So, if you... Me and Jake love talking about movies, but we also love making movies. So
it's true. Luke is an actor.
I'm an actor, and Jake is a filmmaker.
Oh.
So what a perfect duo.
So go check out Grandpa George is Dead. Tell us what you really think.
And Jake used to be an actor as well.
Hey, sometimes.
Jake played, sometimes. Get this. Me and Jake were in a production of Beauty and the Beast. Jake was the Beast, and I was Gaston.
And we rocked
I think
it.
People would pay big money to see that right now.
Big money.
Big.
Big, big, big money.
Big money. So what's next?
Well, next I'm going to move my laundry.
Okay.
Because I am worried. And then we're going to turn some more lights on. Because it's getting dark in here.
All right, now to the main segment of the episode.
Now that we have some more lights.
Yes.
My laundry is safe.
Yeah, look, Jake's, a storm's moving in. So.
It's getting heavy.
It's getting heavy out there.
Perfect timing.
Perfect timing for the Battle of the Century.
Where the cold and warm fronts meet. That is where the storms are made.
So today we're going to be talking about the two biggest comic book universes when it comes to film. We're not talking about the comic books because we don't read comic books.
Not really.
Well, we've read the biggest ones. But we're talking about DC versus Marvel.
And we know who already has won this fight.
Yeah. So
not much of a fight.
Yeah, there's kind of a no contest here, but we're going to kind of dissect why we feel the way we do and what we feel towards both of these two movie universes. If you've listened to the podcast before, you know we're not big fans of Marvel.
No, not fans.
No.
Like some people, they're just fans in that like no matter what Marvel releases, they'll go see it and love it. because they're just fans.
Yeah.
It's like Harry Potter fans.
Yeah.
Every Harry Potter movie is amazing.
Yeah.
Or Star Wars. Every Star Wars movie is amazing because you're a fan. Yeah. Whereas we're not fans. We like good movies. So if it's not good, we're going to tell you.
Yeah. And that goes for both DC and stuff. So a little bit on our background, you should know that, like, our favorite superhero is Batman.
That's a huge bias.
Obviously. So there's a huge bias there. We love Batman. Christopher Nolan's trilogy, nothing will beat it.
Yeah.
For us. Unless something great comes along.
It's
special, and The Dark Knight is in our top 10 favorite movies of all time.
It is.
Yeah. So it's a big deal.
Tis.
So that may be in part why we're not the biggest fans of DC right now with the path that they've taken our favorite superhero on. But let's just...
quick history lesson. Marvel and DC, they were both like the competing comic book universes. So what that means is they're kind of yin and yang.
Yeah.
It's not like good and evil, but they perfectly match one another in the weirdest ways.
Yeah.
For instance, they each have their own versions of each other's heroes.
Yeah.
To the point where, like, both Marvel and DC have their own, like, they have both have multiple ice villains.
Yeah.
They both have multiple universes.
Yeah.
Which involve multiple versions of their own heroes. They each have their own sort of, like, Batman and Iron Man have a very similar, they're like billionaires to each other. They have like things like that throughout it, like hundreds, if not thousands, of different characters and stories and scenarios where they were trying to sell these different things. Now, where things stick out to pulp culture are things like Marvel has the X-Men.
Yeah.
Marvel is Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Marvel, you know, so those are like the big things. And of course, what we know is the Avengers and whatnot. DC, that's Batman, Superman, Wonder Woman, The Flash.
Yeah.
You know, and the Justice League. And so the Avengers and Justice League are like, again, yin and yang sort of thing.
Yeah.
Now, they existed as comic books where they were able to, you know, they were able to be that. People would go and they would buy these little comic books and it was a sort of a niche thing. Then they started making movies and TV shows.
Exactly.
So there was like the Fantastic Four TV series. And it's awful.
Yeah.
There was...
And there's the famous Batman TV series with Adam West.
Which
there's,
is fun.
There was a Superman series way back when in the 50s. Way back when.
There was even a cartoon in the 40s.
Yeah, and then there's the animated series, which were great.
Yeah.
Spider-Man animated.
Oh.
Amazing.
X-Men.
Batman. X-Men First Class I watched pretty, like... was it called First Class?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was called X-Men Evolution.
Class. Yeah.
It was X-Men Evolution.
Which I was obsessed with as a kid.
Well, I was really big into Justice League.
Yeah.
Yeah. There was a Superman TV show. Ton of it.
Yeah. So everything kind of... to talk about more about the history... Oh, and the reason we're talking about this today is today the Thor trailer came out. Ragnarok. So that came out... And then we have this Facebook thread discussion with our friend Max, who's been on the podcast. And Max is a diehard DC fan, loves DC and stuff.
As he said, his most anticipated movie of the year is not Dunkirk, it's not Star Wars.
It's Justice League. Yeah, so, and that raises, like, Jake raised a point that, no, like, Spider-Man, I'd rather see Spider-Man and Thor and Guardians way over seeing Justice League or Wonder Woman. It just... So that's why we're having this discussion today. Now, a little bit of more about the history. So this all this amounted to a huge change around 2007, 2008, because DC was releasing their biggest powerhouse, The Dark Knight.
Yes.
Which had the biggest hype because Heath Ledger died, and we knew what we were going to get was going to be amazing. And it transcended the movie universe. The Dark Knight actually changed everything. Changed the Oscars.
There's no going back.
Yeah, seriously, because that's why we have more than 5 Oscar nominations, purely because The Dark Knight was snubbed out of the Best Picture race. So, stuff like that. But then also in 2008, Iron Man was released.
Which was the beginning of the MCU.
Yes. So, Kevin, I don't know how to say his last name.
Feige?
Okay. If you go back and watch him in 2007 at Comic-Con, he talks about, and the crowd gets pumped up by this. He's like, yes.
Because they're all diehard.
Yeah, he's like, we're going to do Iron Man. He's like, followed by the Incredible Hulk with Edward Norton, blah, blah, blah. He's like, just imagine a world in which these characters come together in one film.
Which had never been done like that.
And the crowd starts screaming. He's like, imagine something like the Avengers. Okay? And he sat down with his group of producers and they planned. You watch the end of Iron Man, it fuels into Incredible Hulk.
It all starts to pull
it
together.
And they planned, they mapped out what they were going to do, followed by the Avengers. Where DC at the time, they were just concentrated on
sort of standalone movies.
Yeah,
so which is how it was done before. I mean, there were movies like the X-Men, but that was one movie that always followed this team. There was never anything quite like this, pulling this together. We've described it as like the longest TV show in history.
And this is Marvel Studios. There's a difference. Like, Sony owns Spider-Man, and 20th Century Fox owns X-Men. So they're all so Marvel split up. But Marvel Studios, which was bought by Disney in like 2010, 2011, after Iron Man and those came out, that's the one that we're kind of concentrated on today. But they were genius because DC, again, they were concentrated on standalone films, and then they had a really crappy reboot of Superman, Superman Returns, that didn't do well. And then they decided after, was it Rises? I think Dark Knight Rises.
Well, Superman Returns was 2006, I think.
So but I mean, Man of Steel. Because Christopher Nolan came on as an executive producer.
I think it must have been...
After Rises.
It must have been after Rises. I think Rises was 2010,
2011,
and then...
So DC sees this growth... Like, Avengers comes out is one of the biggest movies of all time.
And then it's a game of catch-up.
Yeah.
How does DC respond to the MCU?
Yeah.
With the DCCU.
Yeah, so they decided we're going to rush things. Well, at first they didn't. They want to reboot Superman, so they want to make it real. They had Christopher Nolan come on board to try and figure out how to do Superman.
But he wasn't really interested in headlining the whole thing, no. So they bring Zack Snyder in.
And then I remember the trailer. The trailers were awesome.
For Man of Steel.
Yeah, for Man of Steel.
Very exciting.
Very exciting. Looks great. And then the movie, I don't think it's terrible.
But it's not great.
It's not great. But I think it was just as good as like Thor 1.
Sure.
Or even better.
Yeah, I think that's a good point. But what is problematic is that it didn't encapsulate the heart of this hero.
No.
People who are fans
were
not getting their Superman. Whereas Batman, that like Christopher Nolan's Batman universe, that in a lot of ways exemplified a huge contingent of what the fans knew Batman as this dark character that started with Frank Miller's
The Dark Knight Returns. As soon as Begins came out.
Exactly.
They knew it was different.
They were like, this is Batman.
Oh, whereas it's Superman, so good.
You can't do it the same way you do Batman. Superman's supposed to be bright, colorful, full of hope. Yeah. And it's not to say you can't interpret it that way. But whereas Thor, Captain America, Iron Man, and those movies were way more... Those were love letters to fans.
Yes.
Also being vanilla kind of movies that were passable and fun.
And it's amazing. Kevin Feige blows my mind at the way he did this. Because Iron Man was big. And then Incredible Hulk and stuff. They had okay box office. Like, still good. Talking like worldwide, $400 million. Like, that's good. That's great.
They succeeded. They made $100 million or more
budget. To be able to have the patience to know... Because at first it was for fans, but then it started becoming a cultural
thing
that people started being like, we need to get on board with this. And then Avengers came out and everyone saw it.
And everything changed.
And that
it was huge.
Matt, bigger than Dark Knight, bigger than Dark Knight Rises, just the biggest movie.
Lightning.
Oh boy.
We're getting a storm.
Yeah. Massive movie.
And... The storm. I didn't know it was going to be a thunderstorm. I thought it was just going to rain.
I had no idea.
Wow. We're having this discussion about the battle between DC and Marvel. Pathetic fallacy. So, as the storm rages...
As the storm rages outside.
DC decides to amp things up.
And right away after Man of Steel.
And they announce that they're going to do... Well, it's Batman v Superman.
Yeah.
And then it gets... Later on, it gets this weird... subtitle Dawn of Justice.
Yeah.
So we know that they're trying to go for Justice League. We also find out that Zack Snyder's directing it. We also then find out he's also directing
Justice League. We also find out Wonder Woman's going to be in Batman v Superman.
Then we find out that they're going to do a Wonder Woman movie.
Yeah. And then you find out, so they're going to do a Batman v Superman movie, Wonder Woman, and then Justice League all
And time. We're going to throw in Suicide Squad.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to toss that in there. And hey, in the future, we're going to do a Flash, Aquaman, and a Batman movie.
Yeah.
So they decided to do this whole thing upside down.
Yes.
We're going to start with this sort of Avengers-like thing and slowly build on top of that foundation. Yeah. But it's a shaky foundation.
Yeah, they haven't been doing well at all when it comes to people liking their movies.
Critical flops.
But they've been successes at the box office. But you have to think, they have the two biggest superhero properties ever. Superman and Batman are the most recognized heroes ever.
Yeah.
And across that, the globe. That a movie with two of them made less than The Dark Knight and The Dark Knight Rises
is bizarre.
Like that seems like a failure in my opinion.
And it's a failure not just in dollars and cents, because they're still celebrating, but it's a failure in investment for a future fan base.
Yeah.
Because I think they're going to just hurt more and more. And already Wonder Woman has been predicted at the box office to not do well, but we'll find out. And you never know. But then also Suicide Squad was horrible.
Yeah, was horrible.
Universally, no one really liked that movie.
No. Even the diehard fans. And this is the thing, too. I know, like, on my social media, diehard Batman, Superman fans. What else came out that time? Guardians? When it came out? Some Marvel movie came out at that time. I'm trying to remember what it is.
Wasn't it Doctor Strange was a few weeks later?
Then this Batman was only, like, Superman? This was...
No. Oh, I thought you were talking about the Suicide Squad.
No. I just remember when Batman v Superman came out, all my social media were these huge fans saying, what an awful movie. Yeah. A mess of a movie.
Awful.
Because, as we talked about before, we love Batman. Ben Affleck's a good Batman, but the way he's portrayed, and if you go back and watch that movie, like he's killing people left, right, and center.
Again, it's not fulfilling what is expected and known as this character. And it's not even a reinvention.
Yeah.
It's like we're just going to keep shoving it into this desaturated, messy-looking world.
Yeah.
And I don't think it's paying off. Some people will say, no, well, you know, it's this and that. And I'm not saying it's all absolute garbage, because there are moments of that Ben Affleck's Batman that are exciting, whatever. But the problem is that as a whole, the thing is just a mess.
Yeah.
Like, you might look at Marvel and think, like, oh, it's silly and it's colorful and it's kind of, it's like a circus. But if it's still enjoyable, it's doing better than a movie that, even if it's trying something new, is just falling apart at the seams. Yeah.
Like, I'm not going to lie, going back and rewatching Batman v Superman, like, I'm not a big Marvel fan, because I'm just getting, like, tired of it. Because it's owned by Disney, they can't take certain liberties with certain... Like, Civil War, it made all fans go crazy, but the end of that movie to the beginning, nothing happens.
Nothing changes.
Nothing changes. There's still the Avengers. No one dies. It doesn't matter.
And at the end, they're all, like, they're broken up, but then, like, there's a letter that's like, but hey, we're still friends.
There's no repercussions. And I thought DC could have done something. They could have been like, you know what? We're going to be, like, badass, and we're going to kill Superman, and he's done.
And they do kill him, but then...
Within 5 minutes, he's back, and you know he's coming back, so the... And Justice League trailer, it makes it seem like he's not back, but you know he's back, so that ruins things. So they're not...
I agree.
I don't know. It just...
And now they're talking about doing... Like, they think, okay, well, what did people like about Suicide Squad? Well, they like Margot Robbie.
Yeah.
They like Margot Robbie.
We're going to do this.
Let's do a separate sort of Margot Robbie movie universe. Yeah. The Gotham Sirens, where we take Gotham all City the, Sirens, the famous villains. Because DC has better villains.
Yeah.
Let's take all those famous female villains. Catwoman, Poison Ivy, and
Yeah, but it was all... If Jared Leto's Joker did not go over well.
No.
So now he's their main staple villain. The villains that... The people that they've casted just haven't gone over well. Lex Luthor and Joker are the biggest villains in that universe. And
they failed.
It's just, like, not good watching. Like, it's a shame. I just don't understand. I don't understand how you can have such great properties. And why are you rushing things, DC? Like, take a breath and be like, we know we're going to come out on top in the end. We have Batman.
Yeah.
But no, they decided to just rush it all because they're scared.
And then The Flash can't find a director. There's so many issues trying to find someone to make that movie, because seriously, how do you make that movie?
Well, let's go through their slate.
That's what we want to do.
You'll see what's going on. So Wonder Woman's coming out in June.
Which is being predicted to not do well at the box office.
Yeah, I still think it's too early. I still think it's too early.
But my quip with that thing is that my issue is it looks like Captain America... The DC version.
Yeah.
Oh, we're going back in time to a world war to fight on the side of justice and truth to set up this, you know, important figure.
oh, but it, you know, it's a girl, and oh, she's from this island, so it's kind of like elements of Thor, and kind of, and it's World War One, and it looks, and of course, none of those villains are going to really carry over, because they're going to be from World War One, so yeah. She's going to kill some villain. Oh, we're kind of setting her up, and we kind of winked at it in Dawn of Justice.
Yeah.
I hate that movie. but it still looks desaturated. It still looks it's part of their same universe, so it's that same mold that I'm worried will suck everything that is fun and lovely about comic books mm-hmm. out of the potential.
Yeah. We'll see. I think DC films, I think they look better than Marvel. Because Marvel kind of looks like I'm watching
a television. Except for their more recent ones. Doctor Strange looked awesome. Guardians looks awesome. Yeah, Guardians 2 looks amazing.
The look.
Thor Ragnarok looks incredible.
Yeah, I'm talking like pre what's coming up.
Yeah.
Wonder Woman, I don't know. I'm not, to be honest, the only thing that's I'm excited for right now is Star Wars. So that's taken over every, like anything else. I don't really care. But whatever. It's fine. So we have Wonder Woman. And then a few months later, in November, Justice League.
Yeah.
So they're all coming together. So this seems just like this is a huge year for like Wonder Woman and Justice League, and then we'll get to the Marvel slate. But there's 5 huge comic book movies coming out.
Yes.
And people get tired, I think, after a while. So
that was one of our first podcast episodes, almost a year ago.
Yeah. So
we talked about superhero sickness.
Yeah. So this is. That's crazy. So Justice League's coming out. Then 2018 Aquaman, which is being filmed. I think filming may be completed.
It looks interesting.
Looks interesting. That's coming out end of 2018. So there's this huge gap. Justice League November, and then there's a year until Aquaman.
Now, we've seen a trailer for Justice League, and we've talked about it on the podcast before. But to reiterate, we both think it doesn't look good.
Yeah. The latest trailer...
It does not look good.
The latest trailer was awful.
I don't know what it was.
No, it was a mess.
It was a mess.
Yeah. So, I thought the featurette released before, the 4-minute thing...
Was interesting.
Was interesting.
With Batman.
I was like, okay, this might not be bad, but now it just... I thought it looked so messy, and you didn't know what the action was doing, and you're like... And all the shots of them together, it wasn't epic.
No.
Like, in the first Marvel's Avengers trailer, when they're in the circle, and it's circling around, and Hulk's screaming... And they're in New York City. And... That's exciting.
Yeah.
That's like, they're together, finally. This is like, I don't know who Cyborg is, he looks stupid. I don't know who the Flash is. He kind of looks stupid.
He kind of silly.
Like, it's just like, I don't know. It's a shame.
I think that's what it is. By the end of it, you're trying to describe what you feel, and you just go, I don't know.
Yeah.
If your feeling is so uncertain as like a fan of movies and of superheroes, that's not a good sign.
Yeah. No matter what, it'll make over $100 million first weekend. It's Justice League.
Yeah.
It will, but we'll see if any DC movie ever gets over 50% on Rotten Tomatoes.
That's a good
question. We'll wait and see.
We'll see.
Because it's yet to...
Wonder Woman's got a chance because it's the first
female-led
superhero movie. But then, dude, we'll talk about what Marvel's got coming. But I think if you were to compare the two female-led superhero movies we're going to get, I think one crushes the other.
Yeah. Then Shazam's coming out in 2019. I don't even know who Shazam is.
That's DC?
Yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
And then 2020, Cyborg gets his own movie. Then Green Lantern, Corpse in 2020 as well.
Because that's had a lot of... That's
and
had
then
a lot
these
of
are all rumored. No idea when they're coming out. Nightwing by Chris McKay, who did Lego Batman movies, making a Nightwing movie.
Sure.
Batgirl, Joss Whedon, we talked about a little bit. The Batman, who knows what's going on with that, supposed to have come out in 2019.
It sounds like they're just setting up a Gotham universe.
Yeah. Flash, Gotham City Sirens. And David Ayer is coming back for that.
Oh, no.
He's coming back for Gotham City Sirens. So,
right now it just seems
like they have so many pieces, but they don't, like, wait till we get to Marvel, because they have it lined up. They know exactly what's going on and when things are coming out.
Like,
DC, it's like, when's this coming out? We don't know. We don't know. We don't know.
Well, like, with the DC ones, the idea of Joss Whedon doing a Batgirl movie, that's cool. The guy who did Buffy the Vampire Slayer is going to make this. That's kind of cool. The idea of Matt Reeves doing a Batman movie, that's awesome, because he's a great director.
And he is attached, so...
Yes.
Yeah.
Whereas everything else still is kind of up in the air, we're not sure, and I'm worried that it's dependent upon the success of Wonder Woman and Justice League. Because if Wonder Woman goes over well, great job, DC. You can have standalone movies that do well. Some directors, you know, I'd do a standalone movie.
Yeah.
If I'm given the right kind of freedoms or, you know, whatnot. And then, if Justice League does well, we can pull together these sort of ensemble movies. Yeah. Then Gotham City Sirens or some Gotham City, if it becomes Nightwing, Batman, and Batgirl versus the Sirens or whatever, if that's what it ends up being, then they'll be, okay, cool. But if Wonder Woman and Justice League
both have so many balls in the air and they don't know what to do because they don't know what's going to hit well.
We'll see. We will all see.
Now, and then you have Marvel on the other hand. The
all-star lineup.
Who Marvel has proven, if you're a studio that plans ahead of time and have a definitive plan about how they're going to connect, it's going to work in your favor.
If you're patient.
If you're patient
with it. And they've been, and here we are.
So look at this year alone. We have Guardians 2 coming out next month.
I think it could make $1 billion.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, Guardians 1 made $800 million?
800, I think.
And it was a phenomenon.
Yeah.
Like, you know it's a phenomenon when the merchandising is huge everywhere. They got a cartoon now.
Yeah.
The memes about all of the Guardians. It's huge.
Because it's amazing.
Chris Pratt.
So, this is this year alone, Guardians 2, Spider-Man Homecoming, and Thor Ragnarok.
Spider-Man, who was one of the biggest, probably third biggest recognizable superhero.
And then our friend Max does make a good point that this is the sixth Spider-Man film in
14 years.
But that's a lot.
That doesn't matter for a few reasons. One, we've never seen a teenage Peter Parker. Yeah. Two, we've never seen Marvel actually handle Spider-Man like this.
Three, Spider-Man stole Civil War. People loved him in that.
That's huge. So in my mind, that doesn't matter. I can understand personally you might be sick of watching Spider-Man. Yeah. But I think this is going to be fresh, exciting, new, fun. Yeah. And I'm not saying like any of these movies are going to be my favorites of the year. No. I don't think so. Marvel never really makes it there. But I know for sure it's going to crush anything DC has.
Yes. And then Thor Ragnarok's trailer today was awesome.
That was an incredible trailer.
It was so good. It was exciting. It was funny. It was unique. It had a unique look. Cate Blanchett is in it.
She looks awesome.
She looks awesome. Yeah. They're on a roll. Anyways, then...
If you haven't seen that trailer, watch it. That moment when Thor says, "Yes, I know him. It's so good.
I know him. We work together.
He's my new friend from work."
Yeah.
So funny.
I love that.
Oh, and Jeff Goldblum and Tom Hiddleston.
Awesome
and
cast. Marshall. Amazing cast.
Elba's in it.
So Marvel has 2017, 2018, 2019 planned out to a T. Amazing. Three movies a year. Three huge movies.
My goodness.
So this year could be the biggest. Next year, it's Black Panther. Then Avengers Infinity War, which is stupid big.
Huge.
Like, Guardians is
in
it.
Huge.
Everyone is in it.
It's like 54 named characters or something.
So how are they going to do it?
They're going to do it, though.
It's filmed all on IMAX 3D.
They're going to do it.
It could be the biggest movie of all time.
Yeah.
We'll have to wait and see. Then they have...
Until Avatar 2 comes out.
Yeah. In 2030.
2039.
And then the next one
he's
going
to wait until it's actually when it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
Like,
it'll be a play. Avatar's
in what? It's like 2120, something like that. They're going to wait to 2120 and then release it.
He can just do whatever he wants, though.
Good for him.
Yeah. After Infinity War, though, it'll kind of dip down a little bit. Ant-Man and the Wasp. I don't think anyone's really caring about
seeing But I don't think it'll fail. I think it will do like Doctor Strange.
And it all depends how, like...
And people love Paul Rudd.
Yeah, and how Infinity War ends.
Yeah.
Like, who knows? They may kill off Tony Stark in Infinity War.
Or Captain America.
Yeah.
I think Captain America's going to die.
I think that'd be great.
That's, like, one of the biggest Marvel storylines in the comic books.
Really?
The death of Captain America.
They should. And I don't know who's going to star in Infinity War. Like, who's going to be...
I think it's going to be Captain America and Iron Man.
Yeah. It should be.
And Spider-Man.
Well, the reason I think it's Captain America and Iron Man is there's no Captain America 4 or Iron Man in their slate.
Exactly.
So it's going to be their movie.
But so Black Panther, I think, is going to kill.
Yes.
I think it's going to do really well.
Because people loved him from Civil War.
Exactly. See how they're setting it up?
Yeah.
They're so smart.
They are. It's genius. They've taken the genius of television and they've put it in movies.
So
tying
good.
Things together. People love those credits, those end scenes.
People, you know what? It has changed things that no matter what the movie is...
People stay
thinking there's got to be something.
Yeah.
There's got to be something.
It's like Logan. People stay till the end. No.
Yeah. No.
Guess why?
There was nothing. That was it. It's
that
over.
That was it. After... Then 2019, it'll be massive. Captain Marvel starring Brie Larson. So she'll make
That's
an appearance
huge.
In Infinity War.
For sure.
And then she'll be in that.
She's
then
pretty much a female Superman.
Avengers 2. What? The sequel to Infinity War.
Oh, yeah. Infinity War Part 2.
But it's not called that anymore.
It's called Infinity War, The End of Everything.
They don't have the title yet. Avengers something.
Yeah.
And then Spider-Man 2.
Oh my gosh. That year.
So
they know what they're doing, man.
It's just like insane. And then they're gonna, my hope is this phases out Robert Downey and yep. and then they're gonna reboot
it'll be
new
a,
things.
It'll be a passing of the guard.
Yeah. And then 2020 and stuff, there will be a Guardians 3, there will be certain things.
Yeah. Like that.
But and I heard there may be an Iron Man 4, so
who knows? If there's enough money,
yeah.
why wouldn't he?
It is just that I have such respect for that producer that he mapped this. It is a phenomenon.
Yeah.
And the thing that Disney bought it
is insane. I think it's their biggest thing.
Yeah.
Right?
Because kids love it.
The merchandising is huge.
Yeah.
Everything about it is enormous.
And that's the thing, too. Like, Disney, like, kids can go see the Avengers because there's really no blood, there's yeah. violence with aliens. You can't take a kid to see Dawn of Justice. It's scary.
Yeah.
There's moments of like, yeah, and
it's heavy. And the whole opening credits that a guy's parents get murdered.
Yeah, and
a child's parents get murdered on the way out of a movie theater.
Yeah.
So what do you think kids are thinking when they're watching?
Exactly.
I'm gonna leave, and my mom and dad are gonna get murdered. Yeah.
So but DC's still not playing that dark, edgy tone like Deadpool and Logan do. You know, they're not going to make, DC's not going to make an R-rated Justice League.
Not Justice League. Who knows? They might try and do something down the, like, who knows? Maybe they're Batman. They're like, you know what?
It should
be. You know what?
It should be.
Let's do this. Sirens? You know what?
Yeah. Well, that's a niche in itself. There's all these niches, right?
Yeah.
But most of them are, yeah, Marvel.
It's no competition.
Yeah.
Marvel wins.
Because
the question is, how will DC take this loss? Are they going to keep trying to be different, or are they going to keep try and copy?
Yeah.
And right now, it doesn't look good.
I think they're trying to copy, and yeah. I think like their only saving grace could be, because I don't think Wonder Woman and Justice League are going to change the game. But if they get the Batman right and launch this new,
but that's like
thing,
years,
I know.
Years away.
I know.
And in that time, look what Marvel's going to accomplish.
I know. Well, they're way ahead of the game.
Way ahead.
Yeah. But the Dark Knight still trumps all.
Dark Knight still is the best.
Yeah. Because it's not good for a superhero movie. Like, I go see, like, Guardians. I love Guardians.
Yeah.
I thought it's fun.
It's the best Marvel movie.
And it's the best Marvel movie. And it's like, that's great. But it's not, like, Dark Knight. Dark Knight's a great movie.
Yeah.
Outstanding.
It's what you said before. It transcends superheroes.
Yes.
It's a crime drama.
Yeah.
That happens to involve a vigilante guy dressed up as a bat.
Yeah. Oh, I love all three of those movies so
much.
Me
too.
Even Begins. Begins changed everything. Begins set in motion.
Which is so good.
Just
the gritty reboot.
Yeah. Begins, Casino Royale, all those.
Dude, I love The Dark Knight so
yeah.
much. The movie's incredible.
What do you think? Are you a huge diehard DC fan?
What's wrong with you?
Or are you someone who doesn't even care about comic books? Like, Jess, I took her to see Civil War because I wanted to see
yeah.
it. And she hated it.
Bored out of her
because
mind.
She's not a superhero fan. She's seen some of the movies previously. But she, as an outsider, it's interesting what an outsider thinks. She goes to see this movie and she's like, it's stupid. Nothing happened.
Yeah.
Nothing happened. Yeah, they fought, but there's no moment where you're like, Iron Man's gonna die. Even
and then they're in like Avengers prison.
Exactly. And even War Machine.
Oh,
War
yeah.
Machine, he should have died. It should have been brutal and
yeah.
he should have died.
Instead, he's like, legs are a little weak.
His legs are weak now. So boo.
But thank goodness he has a giant robotic mech suit.
Exactly. So it's servicing the fans and it's servicing kids. But I don't think it's servicing the outside people that are like, hey, let's go check out that. But that's why Guardians was so good, because you didn't have to see any of those previous
yeah.
Avengers movies. You could have just gone to see it and you're like, this is fun. Great cast.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
Even movies like Ant-Man and Doctor Strange, even though they follow the
yeah.
Iron Man formula, they're still more fun and enjoyable movies for a general audience.
Yeah.
Whereas, man, Dawn of Justice,
yeah.
what the? Batman v Superman?
Yeah.
They're not even fighting.
No.
They're like...
Martha.
Martha. Martha. Martha. My life. My mom's name is Martha.
That was laughably stupid.
There are 10 to 15 laughably stupid moments a minute in that movie. Makes no sense.
You know what I recommend you do? Go and watch The Dark Knight.
Go and watch The Dark Knight. That's our recommend.
The acting, just Heath Ledger as the Joker.
That's it.
That's it, man.
That's all you need.
Yeah.
And the pace of that movie.
Pace.
And the tension in that movie.
And cinematography in that movie.
Yeah.
The ending.
Perfect. How it justifies the Patriot Act and Bush spying on U.S. citizens.
Yeah. It does. Yeah.
It at least asks a question that most people would be uncomfortable thinking about, but you turn it into Batman and we can think about it.
A watchful protector. The Dark Knight. Boom. 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 I remember sitting in that theater for the first time and just being like, yeah.
I didn't get a chance to thank you.
Yeah.
And you'll never have to. Oh, check out this guy. Or what does he say? Robbery, double homicide. Armed robbery, double homicide. Leaves a calling card.
Yeah.
And then he turns over the Joker card. Whoa!
Amazing. Stood on its own. Could have leaked into Batman 1.
Yeah, could have.
The first one.
In a way.
Yeah.
Leaves a calling card. Oh, man. What about Escalation?
Escalation.
They start buying, or we care semi-automatics. They buy automatics. We start wearing Kevlar. They buy armor-piercing guns.
It's you're so wearing good. A mask,
jumping off a roof.
It's so real. It's
so
true.
Real. They turn, and I love how they turn the Joker into a terrorist.
Yes.
That's what he is. That's all he's trying to do. He's just terrorizing.